Hi, my name is Jessica and I'm the mental health mom. Thank you so much for joining me today. If this is your first time seeing my videos, then welcome. I hope you like the vibe here. I hope you enjoy Mental Health Monday. Your presence is very much appreciated. If this is not your first time and you are a subscriber, then welcome back. I really appreciate you being here as well. Jumping right into today's topic, this is a concept that is very near and dear to my heart, and that is the concept of ego depletion. A lot of my clients have given me feedback that this has been helpful for them. It's very practical and they can use it every day, and so I wanted to share this with you because I think it's so very important. Now, there is a small disclaimer that goes along with this. I'm not sure how up to date you are on your scholarly articles when it comes to mental health, but in the past couple of years, ego depletion has come under a little bit of scrutiny, not for ethical reasons as far as it being applicable to our lives or it being harmful or anything like that. There has been some debate about whether or not the original experiment that was used to develop the concept was biased. So I just wanted to give you that little disclaimer just in case you wanted to do some more research about the concept of ego depletion after this discussion. I didn't want you to feel that you had been misguided in any way. I try to stay up to date as much as possible on all the current research, and whereas I'm not sure exactly what happened with the original experiment, the jury is still out on, you know, how effective this is when studied in a laboratory setting. I find this to be very applicable to my own life, and I think that the qualitative data is highly observable every day. So, ego depletion refers to a time when an individual is low on cognitive resources, aka energy. Now, why is this important? Well, a lot of us carry baggage around with us every day. Imagine what your own baggage is. I like to refer to it as background noise because it's kind of an inner monologue that we just always have going on. Yours might be a struggle with your weight that's been going on for years. It might be a recent breakup. It could be the death of a loved one that you have not fully finished grieving. Whatever your baggage is, it takes energy to deal with it. And in most cases, we deal with this so well, so habitually, that we don't even realize the amount of energy we are expending to deal with these struggles. With that in mind, these inner conflicts that we have do seem to bother us or be more challenging at some times rather than others. Take a moment and imagine yourself. It's 30 minutes after you've woken up from a very restful sleep the night before. Your first cup of coffee has just started to kick in and everything is going according to plan. You already know what outfit you're gonna wear to work. It's going to be a relatively easy day. You're so glad it's Friday and there's this feeling that you can just take on the world. Now imagine a different scenario. Imagine that you got hardly any sleep. Maybe you had a baby that was crying all night. Maybe your alarm didn't go off and so you were running behind before you even got started this morning. You didn't have a chance to grab that cup of coffee. Traffic was backed up. You got to work and your boss was in a horrible mood and all your customers were unhappy. It's not Friday, it's Monday. And on top of that, you still have to pick up your kids from school and they won't stop fighting in the back seat. And by the time you get home, you can almost see the steam coming out of your ears. Now take a moment to examine your own insecurities. Under which one of the previously mentioned scenarios do you think you will struggle the most with whatever your insecurity is? 30 minutes into the day when you've been well rested and everything is going well according to plan and you haven't had a lot of challenges come up? Or scenario two, where the whole day has been a disaster and you've had one challenge after the other? I think most of us would agree that our inner conflicts and insecurities are a lot easier to deal with under scenario one, where you don't have a lot of other challenges, everything is already going according to plan, and you're able to expend a lot of energy keeping those insecurities at bay. So the important thing to note about this discussion is that your inner conflicts that you already have, your insecurities, the grief of a loved one, the recent breakup you had, all these things are going to seem much bigger. They're going to be magnified at times when you are hungry, stressed, sick, in pain, if you've had a really challenging day. Basically, when your energy is running low, you're not going to be expending the energy to keep those thoughts at bay. Energy that you're expending on a regular basis, but you don't even notice it until it's running low and you can no longer keep those thoughts by the wayside. Now that we know this about ourselves, what are some steps we can take to minimize our insecurities? One, get rid of them. Now, I am not naive enough to think that it's just that simple. I'm a mental health counselor and I wouldn't have a job if getting rid of our insecurities could be done with just the snap of our fingers and then they're gone. I know lots of these insecurities, whatever they may be, have been years in the making. And it could take a lot of really hard work, lots of one-on-one time with a counselor, or maybe a really trusted friend in order to fully resolve these issues that you have with yourself. Whatever the method is that you choose, I do highly recommend that you pursue resolving these conflicts. That is the foolproof way of ensuring that they don't sneak back up on you at times when you're already down. Step number two, if you are already in the process of resolving these issues but are not quite there yet, simply having the understanding that these are going to be more of a challenge for you when you've already had a challenging day will be helpful. That gives you a lot of power. That gives you the perspective and awareness that, okay, perhaps this isn't actually more of a problem for me right now. It just seems magnified because of the situation. And the third step you can take to minimize the impact of your insecurities is self-care, self-care, self-care. If running low on energy is what causes these issues to resurface, then make sure you are taking the opportunity to rebuild your energy reserves. How do you do this? You do this by taking time to yourself. Do something that you enjoy. If you find one task that you have at your job really monotonous and tedious, or even just overly challenging, try to find a way to break it up. Implement something that's a little more enjoyable at various points throughout the day so that you're not spending as much time stressed. So that when your energy reserves start to get a little low, you add in a little dash of something for yourself to build your confidence and energy back up. And then you have more resources to deal with the next challenge. Tini woke up, so she's gonna co-host for the rest of the video. So lastly, now that you have an understanding about why ego depletion happens and why your insecurities are harder to deal with at some times than others, you know, of course, again, at times when you're tired, hungry, stressed, sick, in pain, really safeguard yourself. Be proactive and take steps to make sure you are rebuilding your energy reserves. Make sure you are getting restful sleep. Make sure that you are eating healthy meals throughout the day. Make sure that you are taking time to rest whenever you are getting sick and that you're not just trying to push through it. Taking all of these steps will ensure that you are replenishing your energy and you have enough energy to deal with whatever challenges life has to throw at you, particularly those insecurities that you're used to dealing with throughout the day. Also, remember that you are human and that you're not always going to have a perfect day and that you're not always going to have the energy to deal with all the challenges that life has to throw at you. But implementing the steps that we mentioned, making sure that you're having a proper diet and getting plenty of rest and minimizing stressors within your life where you can. All these things will help you to enjoy your days a little more. All these things will help to keep your insecurities at bay and ultimately lead to a higher quality of life for you and more than likely for those around you as well. I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope you enjoyed my little co-host here. I hold to the belief that we all have the tools we need in order to be our favorite versions of ourselves. And there are certain individuals who come along, such as counselors or maybe really wise people within our lives that are just sometimes there to help us learn how to use those tools. So I hope that you can use this video as a resource and a tool to help you become your favorite version of yourself. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, hit that little bell so that you can receive notifications when we post new videos. We'll be doing Mental Health Mondays every Monday, and so I hope to see you in the next one. If you have a topic you would like for me to cover in the future, please leave that in the comment section down below, or if you have any feedback, I would love to hear that as well. I look forward to hearing from you. Bye!